This is the day that the Lord has made.
Let us rejoice and be glad. And give him
the video. I am so glad to be here in this place, in this space, with you, in the presence of the Holy Spirit. It is a good day.
Just
we can be with brothers and sisters in Christ, and we can be with Christ, come what may. It is a good day. And today is a special day. There are many, many special things about worship this morning. One of them is that it is Worldwide Communion Sunday. So if you are at home, I would invite you
to get some
juice or coffee or water, some sort of bread or crackers, that you will have the elements prepared there at home, that we might all share together in communion, and that it is Worldwide Communion Sunday. This is the one day a year where we pay special attention and focus that Christ is the Lord of all the world, and there are peoples who look different than we do, that speak different languages than what we do, that eat different foods that we do, and yet we are family. And there is one heavenly banquet table set, and all of our names are there. So it is a good day to prepare for us to be the one family of God. So again, this is the day that the Lord has made.
Let us rejoice and be glad.
I will warn you that today's service has many special things in light of the fact that it is communion and in light of the fact that we are holding up the worldwide body of Christ. There will be new languages that you hear. There will be new songs that you sing, and new prayers that we pray together. So open yourself to Christ appearing in so many ways. Let us worship God together. I invite you to join in on the call to worship, and your line is, "Let all the peoples praise him." May God be gracious to us and bless us and make his face to shine upon us, that God's way may be known upon us, that God's way may be known upon the earth. God's saving power among all the nations.
Let all the peoples praise you. Lasia ke I popoli ti lodino.
모든 민족이 주를 찬양하게 하소서.
Que los pueblos te alaben.
Let the nations be glad and sing for joy, for God judges the peoples with equity and guides the nations upon the earth.
Let all the peoples praise you.
Gracias que y popoli ti godino.
모든 민족이 주를 찬양하게 하소서.
Que los pueblos te alaben.
The earth has yielded its increase. God, our God, has blessed us. May God continue to bless us. Let all the ends of the earth revere him.
Let the all the peoples praise you. Lasia que y popoli ti lodino.
모든 민족이 주를 찬양하게 하소서.
Que los pueblos te alaben.
Amen. And our opening hymn this morning, in English, it is Jesus, I Love You. It is our opening hymn, but it is also our opening prayer. This song is a prayer. It's a declaration. And Sam and Jenny Wade are going to be leading us. And Sam, I think you're going to give us some instructions. There's a little sheet in your bulletin that has the words to the song. But it was a good idea.
I'm going to sing it first, and then we're going to sing it one more time to the choir, and then hopefully the whole congregation can do it a third time.
Sarang hamnida, omahanda hayo, o chi, junim hanbunman, kanjori do wan ham nida, namchonare, 주를 향한 내 속에 가망이 주님께로 나 이끌어 주소서 주님을 도완합니다 예수 사랑합니다 사랑합니다 오마한다 하여 오치 주님 한 번만 간절히 도완합니다 문자에 남친 아래 주를 향한 내 속에 갈망이 주님께로 나 이끌어 주소서 주님을 도완합니다
Everyone.
예수 사랑합니다 사랑합니다 오마한다 하여 오치 주님 한 번만 간절히 도완합니다 남천 아래 주를 향한 내 속에 갈망이 주님께로 나 이끌어 주소서 주님을 도완합니다
Survival Korean
Amen Amen, that we have the wonder and the privilege to be able to sing with our brothers and sisters of Korea, Jesus, I love you. Thank you, Jenny. Thank you, Sam. And I invite you now to come to a time of confession. And from Isaiah, these words, remember these things, Jacob, for you, Israel, are my servant. Israel, I will not forget you. I have swept away your offenses like a cloud, your sins like the morning mist. Return to me, for I have redeemed you. This is the word of the Lord. You are invited to confess your sins if you too long to be redeemed. And today we're practicing speaking many languages, but our confession will be silent. And we're invited to especially confess the sins where we have remained silent when we should have said something. Bring your offenses before the Lord. Amen. And now, in various languages of the world, hear the good news of the gospel. In Jesus Christ, we are forgiven.
In Gesù Cristo, siamo perdonati.
Gesù Cristo, anessa, udine, yungso, padassimida.
In Gesù Cristo, somos perdonados.
Blessed be the word of the Lord. And you who have received peace, join in the feast of Christ by sharing that peace with one another. I would invite you to stand and share signs of peace with one another. May the peace of Christ be with you. In our special music this morning, Michelle and Jason are going to be singing a song that we often sing in worship, but generally we sing it in English. But because of their skills and their generosity, we will hear it today in what is my first language, but also in the first language of others who are members of Christ's body. Thank you.
Sonriendo, has dicho mi nombre.
bueno, muy bueno, gracias. And for those of us who do not speak Spanish, the first verse of this is, Lord, you have come to the lake shore, looking neither for wealth, for the wealthy, nor wise ones. You only ask me to follow humbly. O Lord, with your eyes you have searched me, and while smiling have spoken my name. Which is a very fitting hymn, given the scripture passage this morning. Will you pray with me? God, who speaks every language of every peoples on the earth, and you who speak the language of the Spirit, which sometimes we do not understand one tiny bit. We ask, God, that by the power of your Holy Spirit this morning, you would open your special language to us that we would hear and understand and follow. We pray this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. The gospel reading this morning is from John's gospel. And if you remember, like 18 years ago when I was last here with you, we were doing the first part of John's gospel. So this is the next day. After John the Baptist was in the wilderness baptizing and encountering Christ, here we are. Listen to the word of God for you. The next day, there he was again, John with two of his disciples. He saw Jesus passing by and said, "Look, the Lamb of God." When John's two disciples heard him say this, they followed Jesus. And turning around, Jesus saw the two following and asked, "What do you seek?" They said, "Rabbi," which means teacher, "where are you staying?" "Come," Jesus replied, "and you will see." And so they went, and they saw where Jesus was staying, and they spent the day with him. It was about 4 p.m. Andrew, Simon Peter's brother, was one of those two that followed Jesus. One of the two that John had said, "There he is." Now, the first thing that Andrew did was to find his brother Simon and tell him, "We have found the Messiah," that is, the Christ, the Anointed One. And Andrew brought Simon to Jesus. You don't think it's too loud?
No, we weren't.
Okay.
So move it in.
Okay. Back to the story. So, Andrew brought his brother to Jesus. Jesus looked at Simon and said, "You are Simon, son of John. You will be called Cephas," which when translated is Peter, which when translated is rock. Now, the next day, Jesus decided to leave there and go to Galilee. Finding Philip, Jesus said to him, "Follow me." Philip, just like Andrew and Peter, was from the town of Bethsaida. Philip found Nathanael and told him, "We have found the one Moses wrote about in the law, and about whom the prophets also wrote, Jesus of Nazareth, the son of Joseph." Nathanael asked, "Nazareth? Are you serious? Nothing good comes out of Nazareth." "We'll come and see," said Philip. May God bless the reading of this holy word. Here we have the quintessential story of gossip, or the talk around the cooler, the water cooler in the office. One person telling someone else something important. One person telling another person about Jesus. John told Andrew. Andrew told Peter. Philip tells Nathaniel. It is the quintessential story of evangelism at its most basic and personal form. Who told you about Jesus? Do you remember? This is a story about evangelism, about people telling each other about Jesus. But before it's a story about evangelism, it is a story about magnetism. Today's low tide is 0. This evening's high tide is 6.3. Do you ever wonder what has the power to move the seas? That's pretty powerful, isn't it? I watched the moon last night, the crescent moon through the trees. And the moon, as it dances with the earth, there's such a force that it moves the seas. These two bodies which are in orbit of one another. The moon is magnetized. I know that's not the right scientific term, but that magnetic attraction, that power that keeps them in orbit of one another and makes the seas to rise and fall. That's a strong magnetism. Jesus walks through the wilderness, through the village, through the temple with such magnetism that people all around him are drawn in and orbit Jesus' being. For John, that magnetism started in the womb. And then when he saw the dove descend on Jesus. For Andrew, that magnetism, that orbit dance started when he spent a day with Jesus. For Peter, that magnetism, that orbit dance begins when Jesus sees Peter in a way that no one has ever seen Peter before. For Philip, it's when Jesus calls him over. Now, Andrew, when he sees Jesus, when John says, look, when John points, Andrew's question is, where are you staying? Only it's not the kind of verb that's, where's your address so I can find you? It's not the verb that means, what hotel room are you staying in tonight? Where are you sleeping? The verb is abide, remain. What Andrew wants to know is, are you going to be with us? Are you in this with us, or are you just passing through? Jesus, where do you abide? Do you abide in the place where I am wandering? Jesus, do you abide in the place where my heart is breaking? Jesus, will you be there when I am afraid and lost? When the tides of the world are so up and down and chaotic and I feel that I am drowning, where will you stay, Jesus? Andrew's looking for home and wants to know, Jesus, are you it? Jesus asks Andrew, what do you want? Jesus asks Peter, who will you be? Jesus asks Philip, where will you go? These are the basic questions of what it means to be a human, isn't it? What do we want? Who will we be? Where will we go? If you speak English and you live in Lincoln City, these are basic questions. If you speak Spanish and you live in Nicaragua, these are your basic questions. If you speak Italian and you live in the Vatican, you ask these questions. If you are Korean and you live right next to the demilitarized zone, you ask these questions. Andrew is looking for home. Jesus is asking him to clarify what he wants. And after spending time in the orbit of Jesus, Simon says, we have found the Messiah. As Augustine writes, Saint Augustine, who had a troubled heart, says, our hearts are restless until they find their rest in you. It is the magnetism of Jesus, the one who can tell me who I am, the one who can hold us while nothing makes sense, the one who provides the light one step at a time for our path that we will know where we are going. This is the orbit of the Christ. I would encourage you to go home today, and if you have a concordance, look up Andrew and read everything about Andrew in the scriptures. There's not a lot, but there's a few things. There's a couple of places where he is in a long list of the attendance list. Who was here? And all the people, and Andrew's one of them. But all of the things that Andrew does in scripture, every one of them, every time Andrew appears and does something, he's bringing someone to Jesus. That's basically all he does. He tells Peter, hey, I found him. Come and see. When Jesus is with the crowds who are hungry and saying, feed them, it's Andrew who says, I found this boy with some fish. Jesus, can you do anything with that? When there's Gentiles who are seeking for who they are and where to go, it is Andrew who says, come here. Andrew spent a day with Jesus and got caught in this orbit of Jesus's magnetism, Jesus who knows you and knows what you need and has a place to lead you to be at home, to find rest in the heart of God. Be careful if you spend a day with Jesus, because it just might change your life. And you might want to tell someone else. Holy God, for appearing in the wilderness, for walking through the villages, for clearing the temple, for dying on the cross and breaking the power of death, we give you thanks. And we pray that you would capture us in your orbit. And we pray that you would give us the courage and the joy to point to Christ for our friends who are lost and needing home. Amen. Our next hymn is number 318, if you'd like to use your hymnal or follow along on the screen. In Christ there is no east or west. All Christly souls are one in him throughout the whole wide earth. These are the boundaries of our citizenship in the world. They're not the boundaries of any country, but they are the boundaries of the grace of Jesus Christ. In your bulletin are a few announcements. Please look those over and see which orbit you would like to join in on in activities. There's one that's not in the bulletin, but this Thursday, Soup with Friends will be hosted by Michelle. Thank you very much, Michelle. And I think she's excited to show off her lovely new home that you have, your lovely new house that you have transformed into a home. Thank you for your hospitality. Also not in your bulletin is that Thursday morning at 11 o'clock in Camas, Washington, will be the funeral for Nancy Miller. Remember, Nancy Miller used to sit in the back all of the time before the pandemic. She has gone home to be with the Lord, and her family and friends will gather. If you have interest in attending that service, Mark and I will be conducting it. If you have interest in that, let me know, and I will get you the information for that. And this Wednesday, we'll begin the first in the evangelism study on the book of James, 10:30, Wednesday morning. And Elizabeth, do people need to have like read the first chapter, or this week will be introduction? Okay, great. But there are a few more copies of the book in the back of the sanctuary if you'd like to get one. And if they're all gone and you need one, we will order more. Zoom Bible study on Friday, walk on Wednesday, and there are some other things there. So please join in whenever you can. Another special moment that we have in worship today is always a great joy. We will be receiving two new members, so I would invite Harlan and Michelle.
Michelle Hertig, who has been received into membership of this congregation by letter of transfer from St. Andrew's Church, Presbyterian Church in Santa Barbara, and Carla Francis, who has been received into membership of this congregation by confirmation of faith.
Great, thank you. In baptism, you were claimed by God, marked as Christ's own forever, and joined to his body by the Holy Spirit. So you come to us not as strangers, but as friends in Christ and members of the household of God. We rejoice that you now desire to join this congregation in its work and mission of the Church for Christ. Hear these words. There is one body, one Spirit, just as you were called to one hope of your calling, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all and through all and in all. Michelle, do you want to say one or two things that you would like the congregation to know about you?
I am a mother of two fantastic young men. They're 20 and that are 20 and 22. One lives in Arizona, one's in Portland, so I get to see him on occasion. And they are probably the main driving force in my life. The other thing is that I've always been a naturalist, so I love being in the ocean and the woods and looking at the birds and the animals, and I have lots of elk at my house.
Carla, what are you, although Carla has been attending with us for years, but what one or two things would you like?
Well, I'm also a mother. I have two bright and beautiful children. They're well older than yours. My daughter Kimberly and my son Christopher. I also have two bright and beautiful grandchildren, Emma and Tyler. Emma is attending Oregon State University, and Tyler is in his senior year of high school. And I also have a husband that helped me to bring these two beautiful children into the world. So, and he and I have been married for about 50 years, so good for him, he stuck it out. Former social worker, that was what I did professionally. I also graduated from Oregon State University as well as Portland State University, so go Oregon. That's all.
Great, thank you. And both of them have already generously demonstrated their discipleship to Christ and sharing their gifts at Chapel by the Sea. So we are thrilled to be able to walk this journey of discipleship with you. Michelle and Carla, will you be a faithful member of this congregation? Share in its worship and mission through your prayers and gifts, your study and service, and so fulfill your calling to be a disciple of Jesus Christ. If so, say, I will with God.
I will with God's help.
Let's pray. Holy and gracious God, we give you thanks that you have called each one of us into the orbit of Jesus Christ. And this morning we are especially thankful that you have called Michelle and Carla to serve out their discipleship through Chapel by the Sea. May you continue to pour your spirit and your gifts in them. May we receive those gifts and give them nurture. May our prayers be mingled together as we all seek to serve you, to point to your Son, Jesus Christ, and to give witness to your work in the world. Amen. Thanks be to God, and welcome to Chapel Night.
You're welcome.
And I As the one on the lake shore who said, I don't have wealth, I don't have power and prestige, but I bring you what I have. Bring whatever it is that you have to the Lord and offer it. It's the kind of offerings that go in the plate, get mailed in, the kind that you offer by pointing to Christ, the kind that is in your hands and in your actions. Bring all these offerings to the Lord. Holy God, we give you thanks for the gifts that we have received, and we ask that you would take these gifts and that you would bless them, that you would use them as pointers to your Son, Jesus Christ, that all might find their home in him. Amen. Our hymn this afternoon, this morning, Come Sup with God. They're, again, on the insert in your bulletin, these words are on the back. We're going to sing the first three verses before communion and the last two verses after communion. And these first verses are the invitation, the reminder that you are invited to this table. So will you sing with me the invitation to Christ's table? Invited to this table. And at this table, this is the reminder of the heavenly table. People will come from east and west and north and south and will take their places at that feast in the kingdom of God. As we come from east and west and north and south, we come with hungers of various kinds as we wait for that heavenly feast table of God, which will be laden with all that we need, and we will be fed and satisfied. Some of us will wait. Some of us will wait with pita bread on our tables. Today we remember our brothers and sisters in Lebanon and Israel and Palestine, Afghanistan, Iraq, who live in the midst of conflict and war, and we pray with them for peace, for the peace of Christ to break forth. We thank them for their witness of courage that they bring to the table. Some of us wait with corn tortillas on our table. We remember those who are natives to the Americas, our brothers and sisters who seek to honor the integrity of creation, and we pray with them for the healing of Christ to break forth upon the earth. We thank them for the witness of reverence that they bring to the table. Some of us wait with rice on our tables. We remember our sisters and brothers in Asia who are the first to greet each new day, and we pray with them for the humility to treasure each new day that is given to us. We thank them for their witness of respect that they bring to the table. And some of us wait with rye bread on our tables. Our brothers and sisters across Eastern Europe who have maintained and passed down the faith in and out of season for generations. We pray with them that as modernization and technology spread, that the love of Christ would grow deep. We thank them for their witness of stamina that they bring to the table. And some of us wait with an empty bowl on our table. We remember the people of the world who woke this day in hunger and will go to sleep tonight hungry. We remember our brothers and sisters who struggle to survive, and we pray with them for Christ's provision. We thank them for their witness, which keeps us humble and alert. It reminds us to put away our greed. And at that table long ago, it was Christ who brought himself, and he took bread and he gave thanks to God for it. And then he broke it and he said, this is to remind you that my body is broken for you. And he told the disciples to eat it. And at that table, he took the cup. And he said, this is the cup of the new covenant, for the forgiveness of your sins, for grace and mercy poured out, that I have sealed this promise in my own life. Take and drink deeply. This is the feast of God for the people of God. God bless this table, that it will be for us sustenance along the journey and transformation of all the world. Amen. I would invite the deacons to come forward. Here's the logistics this morning. You are invited to come forward down the middle aisle. You can choose the bread you want. Gluten-free is here. Choose the bread that you want, and then go back, and a deacon will hand you a cup. Return to your seat, and then we will take communion together. as a symbol that we are one in the body of Christ. Come, people of God, for the feast is prepared for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. The body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. The body of Christ broken for you. The body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. The body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. The body of Christ broken for you.
Amen.
This is the body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. If you would prefer, Scott will bring the communion elements to you if you just want to raise your hand. Elizabeth, this is the body of Christ broken for you. Gay and Melissa, this is the body of Christ which is broken for you. The cup of salvation poured out for you. The body of Christ broken for the world's healing. The cup of salvation poured out for the redeeming of humankind. Let us eat and drink deeply. Of course, the person with the microphone takes the crunchiest. And the prayer after communion today is borrowed from our brothers and sisters of Chile. Holy God, for this bread, for these gifts, we praise you.
Por este pan, por este don, te alabemos, Señor.
Amen. And now we're going to sing the last two verses of the song, Come Sup with God. So I charge you to go out in the world, to see the point, to get the point, to point to the point, and find your rest in Christ. And now for our blessing. May the Maker of all grant you love for all.
Il Redentore in tutti ti conceda grazie fra tutti.
모든 것에 창조주께서 당신에게 모두를 향한 사랑을 주시게.
Que el Hacedor de todos lo conceda tu amor por todos.
May the Redeemer of all grant you grace among all. And may the Helper of all grant you peace with all.
Que el auxiliador de todos nosotros te conceda la paz con todos.
Amen. Go into the world where Christ is everywhere.